pattern. So first of all, what is the meaning of the pattern? What is the definition of the pattern? So pattern is nothing but it is one of the replica of the pattern, and which are going to manufacturing the pattern output of the our product. So pattern having, it carries the some properties and also has the some allowances also. Suppose we require the pattern, like for example, it's a 30 mm, but in preparing of the pattern, we have to give that more than the required dimension. So that's why it carries the some allowances, and also the pattern also has some properties also should be having, capable of withstanding the high temperature and also moisture and also refractoriness. There are some pattern allowances also there. We will discuss one by one. So first, we will discuss the there are some different types of the pattern. So patterns are can be classified into the some different types. The first type of the pattern is called as a single piece pattern or solid piece pattern. So nothing but the pattern is nothing but without having any joints or any the clubbing of the pieces, that pattern is called as nothing but a solid pattern or single piece pattern. Our next type, second type of the pattern is called as a split pattern. The split pattern is nothing but here, in case of the some pattern, it's a very difficult to handle or it's very difficult to withdraw from the mold cavity. So at that time, we are preparing as a split up into the two parts. So that pattern is called as a here, the split pattern. And the third pattern, it is called as a cope and drag pattern. There is a heavy pattern. The box itself, we are making as that the half part should be in the cope box and half part should be in the drag part. So that pattern is called as a cope pattern and drag pattern. And another one, that is the fourth pattern, is called as a mass plate pattern. So some of the patterns, some of the replica of the pattern, just small pieces, it's a very difficult to handle in the pattern. We are kept in that boxes. So at that time, we are keeping in between the two boxes, that is a cope and drag boxes, we are keeping the plate. So that is a plate is called as a mass plate. So that pattern is called as a mass plate pattern. Another one, that is a pattern is called as a gated pattern. So coming to the production point of view, they have a continuous production or mass production. So some of the pattern have a small pieces. So directly attaching to the either to the gate or either to the riser or either to the runner. So those pieces, that pattern is called as a gated pattern. And another pattern, the sweep pattern. So sweep pattern is here. So whatever the pattern, they having any symmetrical object. So at that time, you have to make it as only one side. So at that, after that, you have to make it as revolving to the, their respective axis. So that type of pattern is called as a sweep pattern and a loose piece pattern. So patterns having the while removing the withdrawing from the molding boxes, the molding shaft should be going to disturb. So at that time, we are adding the some pieces to the pattern. So that is the pattern is called as a loose piece pattern. And the scatter pattern and cell pattern, we will discuss one by one. So first type of the pattern, it is called as a solid piece pattern or single piece pattern. So coming to the solid piece pattern or single piece pattern, so this pattern is a very simple and very easy to withdraw from the molding boxes or either from the cope or either from the drag. So this pattern, it doesn't have the, any joints and there is not a split up into any pieces. So that is a pattern, the name itself gives the single piece. So that's what is called as a solid piece pattern or single piece pattern. So mostly wherever required that continuous production, it doesn't have any joint or it doesn't have they are very sufficient to remove it from the molding boxes. So their application varying the single piece pattern. So you see the diagram here. The single piece pattern, you can see the diagram. So here there is no joint in the pattern. So here it is very easy to remove from the molding boxes, and this pattern should be kept in only in the one particular box, that is in the drag boxes. So here there is no joint and there is no split up, and wherever having the suitable for only for the simple objects. If having the some object and some coming to the application point of view, that pattern having the some complexity. So for that complexity point of view, the single piece pattern is not suitable. So at that time, you can go for the split piece pattern. So split piece pattern is is also called as a two-piece pattern. So the pattern consists of the two pieces or three pieces or called as a multi-piece pattern. So coming to the two-piece pattern, here require that scope and drag boxes. If the pattern should be the more than the two pieces, that pattern is called as a multi-piece pattern. So at that time we require the one box, and it's called as a cheek box. So I'll show the diagram here. So in case of coming to a split piece pattern, the half part of the portion should be placed in the bottom box, that is drag box, and half part of that piece it should be in the top part, that is called as the cope box. So I'll show the diagram here. So here the two pieces parted. So these two pieces are joined by the line. That line is called as a parting line. And these two pieces are joined by the pinch, that is called as a double pinch. So here, in case of coming to the previous one, the solid piece pattern, while withdrawing from the pattern, it's a very difficult to, it can disturb the entire molding set. So at that time, we are going to split up into the two parts. And after that, we are joining these two parts with the help of the double pinch. That line is called as a parting line. You can see the diagram here clearly. The half part of the pattern should be kept in the drag box. And remaining half portion, it should be kept in the cope box. So these pieces should be joined with the help of the double pinch. So sometimes, depends on that, if it is more than the two pieces, that part is called as a multi-piece pattern. So at that time, we require the three boxes. The top box is called as a cope box, and the bottom box is called as a drag box. In between the cope and drag box, we have to add some another box, that is called as a cheek. So here the line in between the two patterns, the line is called as here, the line is parting line. So here you can see the diagram, the multi-piece pattern. So here, this part should be kept in the cope box and the drag box, and the middle part should be in the cheek. So 1, 2, 3. So here we have three parts, that is called as a multi-piece pattern or three-piece pattern. If the pattern having the joints more than two pieces, that is called as a three-piece or multi-piece pattern. So here, we require the three boxes. So top box, it should be in the cope box, and the medium should be in the cheek, and bottom should be in the drag box. So coming to two piece pattern, we have only the cope and drag boxes. So next, another type of the pattern, that is called as a cope and drag pattern. So the previous one, that is a two piece pattern. So coming to that, take any kind of automobile engines. So those engines is a very difficult to draw. Make a product in the small pieces. So at that time, those parts, the size of the parts should be very, very heavier. So those parts, it should be kept in a totally in the either in the drag box or in the cope box. So that pattern is called as a cope and drag pattern. So you see the diagram here. This part entirely should be kept in the cope. Same similar to the two-piece pattern. So here very simple is the pattern should be totally kept in the cope box and the other part should be kept in the drag box. So that's what is called as a cope pattern and drag pattern. So next, another type of the pattern, that pattern is called as a masonite pattern. So some patterns are like take any kind of the links. That link should be that having that holding and also the placing in the molding boxes should be very difficult. So at that time, what I am doing here, that part should be attached in the one plate. So that plate should be, we have to keep it between the two boxes. So that plate is called as a mass plate pattern. So I'll show the diagram here. So in case of the mass plate, so this is a plate is called as a mass plate pattern. So here these two pieces, are having that object should be the like in irregular in shape. So at that time, that kind of the object is a very difficult to place on that either in the cope box or in the drag box, like a any curved line type link mechanism. So that kind of the link we have to attach it on the plate. So either in the cope or either in the drag boxes. So that attach on that plate. So that plate is called as a here mass plate pattern. You can see the diagram here. So the top part, it should be like a pure solid surface, like a flat surface. On the top layer should be the like a curved portion. So in the curved portion, if you keep it in that cope box or in the drag box, while removing of that from that molding sand, it should be disturb entire the molding sand. So we can't able to get our desired output. So at that time, these parts should be we are attaching on the plate. So that is a plate here. So this one is called as a mass plate pattern. Next, another type of the pattern, it is called as a gated pattern. So coming to the continuous production or mass production process, the very very small size of the product, so we can't able to produce every time for the small pieces in, we can't able to waste in the time and also production and missing process. So in case of the small parts, so like the small parts, we have to attach on the gated or either in the runner or either in the riser. So here the all the small pieces we can attach directly on the both either side of the riser and runner. So that kind of the pattern is called as a here gated pattern. The name itself gives the gated pattern. So you see the diagram here. So here when you are pouring the molten metal from the scope to the it can flows into the runner. So inside either both the side, like a small kind of the pieces or either kind of any kind of the object, we can keep it at the side. So that's what is called as a gated pattern. Either we have to attach it to the either in the riser side or gate or either from the runner side. Either in the from the so this part is called as a runner. So this part is called as a gate. So here in case of the gate, the we are making as a small channels, then we are adding the small pieces pattern. So this process is best suitable for the mass production, continuous production process. So that's what is called as a gated pattern. Whenever we have the small pieces, so can here in this process we can able to reduce the time and also increase the efficiency of the production rate. So this is a pattern is called as a sixth one, sweep pattern. So when the pattern having the symmetrical or the circular section, so here we can able to increase the or we can reduce the size of the part here. So we can able to produce only half part of the pattern because it should be in the symmetrical shape. After making the half part of the pattern, we can able to revolve along to their respective axis. Then we can able to get the full product. So here, I'll show the diagram here. So this is the kind of the object, like a symmetrical axis over the y axis. I can able to produce only this part only. So that's why here we can able to save the material of the pattern. And also here, this part is part of the knob. After preparing this part, we can able to rotate or revolve along to their respective axis. Whatever that shape, mirror image, it should be formed in the this side. So that type of the pattern is called as a sweep pattern. And next, another type of the pattern, it is called as a loose piece pattern. So object having that a very difficult to withdraw from the molding sand. So at that time, we are adding the some kind of the pieces. So that piece is called as a loose piece pattern. So here, it shows the diagram here. So like this kind of the object we have. So while removing of this pattern, so entire this part, it should be disturbed by entire the molding sand. So what we are doing, this part here, we are separating from the pattern and then we are adding after the preparing of the cavity. So that piece is called as here, loose piece pattern. So actually our final product is like this one. If we keep it like this one, when we are removing the entire part from the molding sand, so here the surface area should be smaller compared to the bottom part. So this part, it should be disturbed entire one. So automatically the entire final product will get this kind of the shape. But with our required object is here, this is a small, this is a bigger one. So here, what I am doing, this entire bottom part, I am making divided into the small pieces. That's what is called as loose pieces. So you can see the diagram here, divided into small pieces. After making the pattern, removing from this part, then we are adding to these parts. So that is called as pieces. This part is called as a loose piece pattern. And next, another type of the pattern, it is called as a skeleton pattern. A skeleton pattern is like a hollow shape of the pattern. So it consists of the wooden frame and rib. The hollow portion, it should be filled with the help of the some kind of the clay sand or either loam sand here. So in a part consists of the internal part should be the hollow type product. So at that time, we are making a special type of the sand here in case of the skeleton pattern. Otherwise, that hollow part we can't able to get in the skeleton pattern. So you see the diagram here, in case of skeleton pattern, the internal part of the pattern, it should be the hollow shape. So here, so inside of this pattern, it should be like a hollow shape pattern. This is a hollow,
like interval fault, it should be a hollow pattern. So here we can add, we have two cartridges. We can add either in core or either we can able to produce it there from the spatial shunt also. So here I mean type of the pattern is skeleton pattern. Otherwise we can go for the another type of the material that is called as a core. So interval fault, it should be totally the hollow material. So here I am attaching the like a special kind of a shunt, either lobe shunt or either molding the parting shunt. So that should be stick into the on this part. So then after that, this entire part should be the hollow kind of material. So the side view of the this object. So now next class we discuss the different pattern materials. So today I am going to stop here. Thank you.